Welcome back. Today we're going to be doing a nighttime birch forest. So I've taken my canvas here and I've actually coated it already with black because we're going to have, it's going to be a night scene. So for the sake of time, I've just already gone ahead and done that. And actually I coated over a previous project so you can, as we've discussed before, we can reuse canvases if you're not, if you're not happy with the painting that you did before. You can just coat over it and start a new one. Okay, so first, so I've coated over this. So we have today, we're only using four colors. We're using the titanium white, using a black, a sort of a pale yellow, but you can use any kind of yellow you like. And I'm using a metallic green. You can use any kind of green you like. It really doesn't matter. Okay, so these are the only four colors we're using, and I'm actually using a piece of tin foil today as my palette. I'm trying to show you different easy ways to paint so that you don't have to go out and purchase a bunch of expensive supplies. If you want to paint, you can paint on anything. You don't even need a canvas. You can paint on a piece of paper, a piece of cardboard. Just go ahead. That's the main goal. Let's go out and paint something. Okay, so I'm going to start by, I have my trusty old little water and my little paint rag here to blot my brush on. So I'm going to go into some water. I'm actually going to just do a light coating of black here, just as we've talked about before, to have a little bit of wetness underneath. Whoops. It doesn't have to be the whole thing. We're just kind of getting a little bit of wetness underneath. As we go along, sometimes we like some of that wet paint to come out underneath, come out from underneath. Okay. All right, so we've done that. That's really easy. Now, what we want, this is going to be sort of like a forest, a birch forest. So, we want to start to make like little indications of that there's some birch trees in the distance. So I'm going to take out some of the white. My brush is a little bit wet. I'm loading it, but I want it to sort of be, I'm going to use the edge. See how thin the edge is? And I'm going to go here and I'm going to just start making little indications that there might be some trees in the distance. Okay. And you see the wet paint is kind of coming through, giving it a little bit of shading or just a little bit of dimension. So I'm just going to put a few here. There. And don't worry too much about how they look at this point. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we want to go in and start painting some of the trees that are going to be showing up closer in the front of the painting, or towards the foreground of the painting. Now, for this, I think I'm going to go in and I'm going to use sort of my medium brush there. That one I was using my large brush with. I'm going to load up my brush with the paint and I'm going to start painting in a couple of the larger birch. So I'm going to put a little more pressure on the brush. I want to be a little more straight with those. I'm going to come out like this. Okay. I don't know. I have a few. Some lining up the brush. And again, I don't have much time here with this, but I'm just trying to give you an idea of some of the techniques that you can use to go off and just make your own fabulous painting. Okay, so there we go. Now, what I'm gonna do, and you see how some of that black that we painted on had come through and it gave it a little bit of dimension and maybe some shading because it's supposed to be nighttime. Okay, so now I'm gonna go and take my little tiny brush here. And to start, I'm gonna take some of this already wet paint here and I'm gonna kind of like make some little branches that I'm going to extend out. Okay, and then I'm going to drag it down. There we go. Now, I'm going to just do a little bit for each one to get as much of the paint as I can from the actual tree trunk that we just painted. Okay? All right, now I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna get a little more white. And I'm gonna sort of trace over those with a little more bright white just to kind of make some of them pop a little bit more. There we go. Sort of bring down a little more of the straight white into the trunks. Okay. All right. That looks good. Okay. So now what we want to do is I want to add some of the foliage. Okay. So we're going to take, I think I'm going to take my medium brush here. Okay. And I'm going to go into a little bit of the green, this is metal green, just for a little bit of flair, that's all. And I'm going to bring, but you don't have to use that. I just sometimes like to use some metallic colors, and they're not expensive. Again, you can get them at any craft store. You don't have to spend a lot of money. It's just like you can get little tubes of little jars of acrylic paint for around 99 cents to roughly $3. The metallics are a little more pricey, more towards the $3. But they do add a little bit of interest. Okay, so I'm gonna mix this. See, I'm just gonna kinda, you don't have to mix it thoroughly. I just wanna kinda get all of the tones there. Okay, so now I'm gonna go up here and I'm just gonna start putting on the little leaves. And you see how it's pulling out some of the paint? We want that because it really adds some dimension. You really kind of don't know what you're going to get. Just kind of let it happen. There we go. Figure out where you want those leaves. We're going to load up our brush again. You see how I didn't mix it thoroughly? So we have some of the yellows coming through. We're pulling out some of the black behind. I'm just going to put it on here. Starting to take shape. And again, it's hard to tape and paint at the same time, but I am hoping to get a tripod soon, so that will help out a bit. There we go. Over here. Might want a little more green. And this is just, you can do this whatever you feel, however you feel that you want your trees to look like. Just kind of filling up the background there. There we go. Okay. Alright, so, okay, we had a little tech issue there. Okay, so we're back. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take my larger brush and I'm going to go in and I'm going to get some of the yellow green tones. And I'm going to sort of make a little bit of land down here. Okay. There we go. In the foreground. Obviously those background trees aren't floating in the air, but I'll bring out a little bit of this there. Okay. And then you might want to go in and you can take a little white and make this green and yellow mixture. And you can kind of take your brush and do something like this. There we go. And use the side. Whoops. Kind of maybe make a little indication of some grass. Something like that. Okay, now I want to take my larger brush and I want to go work a little bit more on these leaves up here and I'm going to kind of load it up. Okay, and I'm going to start to just do a little more with the side of the brush. And a few more leaves. There we go. one more depth. This is a birch tree. I'm going to kind of use the edge. Okay. There. Okay. Have a nice little couple of birches there. And I'm going to take my really tiny brush. And I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to load it up with some black. And I'm going to go into those little small ones and just put a little indication of some deep, the deeper forestry, some little lines in there. These a little more of a indication that they're actually grounded. There we go. So I'm just kind of paint over there, and that just sort of brings them back into the. I'm gonna take a little more, get a little heavier black. There. It's gonna bring them, give the painting a little more depth. Kind of back there in the distance, and you can see how it looks a little darker back there, but that's because it's wet, so once it dries it's gonna just sort of blend in there. Okay, there we go. So let's see how that brought the trees back into the deeper into the forest. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is this area has started to dry, and as I said, this is acrylic paint, so acrylic paint dries much more quickly than like oil. So we have to work a little more quickly. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add some more, mix a little brown, a little black and a metallic green together to make it deeper green. Okay, there. And I think I'm just gonna add a few more, brush strokes in here. Okay, now I'm gonna, for the last thing, before we go, I'm just gonna put a few of these darker tones. Actually, you know what, I think I'm gonna use the medium brush here. And I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna get some of this darker color that we made. And I'm gonna put a little bit of that up there. Just sort of maybe just sort of on the side of each little clump of trees to give it a feeling of a little more darkness. Because you have to have the darkness to show the light. I want to start to give these a little bit of shape. Alright, well, we're out of time. I'm going to continue to work on this. Thank you very much for joining me, and I will see you tomorrow.